Hi everybody, this is Matteo Ghidoni for Fred Film Radio, the Festival Insider. We are on the rooftop of the London Hotel at the first edition of the ITTV Festival, the first festival entirely dedicated to Italian TV series. I'm here with Stefania Spampinato, Carina De Luca in Grey's Anatomy. Everybody knows you with that name. How does it feel to be here at the ITTV Festival for you?
It's so exciting, especially because this is the first edition of the festival, so I'm very happy to be supporting this festival. I feel like it means a lot to represent Italian TV in Los Angeles, and I feel like there is more and more productions, co-productions between Italy and the US and the UK. So I feel like this is a very exciting time for us actors, for directors and producers, and big collaborations worldwide. So yeah, very happy to be here.
Which kind of Italian stories do you think could be told abroad, especially here in Hollywood?
It's a very interesting question, actually, because I feel like the stories that I tend to be passionate about, I thought maybe Americans would not like be interested in it, but I felt like there was so many incredible TV shows like La Mica Geniale, My Brilliant Friend, or Gomorra, that tell very Italian stories but have been very successful abroad. So I feel like that's very hopeful to see.
Speaking about Gomorra, L'Amica Geniale, also The New Pope, The Young Pope,
yeah.
All these TV series are both in English and Italian. Well, not Gomorra, but you know, they are not dubbed. People is getting used to see this kind of TV series watching subtitles. How do you think subtitles and this kind of fruition is opening the market for Italian filmmakers and actors too?
Well, I feel like the Western, like the rest of the world aside from Italy has always been exposed to subtitles. A lot of the Northern Europe, they watch TV shows with subtitles. America watches Spanish and Italian TV show and cinema with subtitles, so I feel like they're more open to it. We in Italy have still a very strong tradition of dubbing, so we are not as exposed to that, which is a little bit of a shame because you miss a lot of nuances and I miss a lot of the truth, but also it's kind of distracting to keep having to watch, like to read underneath. So it's there's good in both. I prefer subtitles, but yeah. I feel like it's more and more people are, like, the new generation especially is getting used to that.
TV series are becoming more and more important. Budgets are bigger. The audience is bigger and bigger every year. So how do you think the market is changing right now?
TV happens faster. While sometimes to make a movie you need 7-8 years from the minute you start thinking about it to the minute you finally start shooting it, TV can happen like literally over a night. And I feel like that allows you to produce and to develop more stuff. And because there is a lot of consumers, a lot of people watching TV, there is a lot of demand for it. And it's also less commitment, because a TV show maybe is like 30, 45 minutes, while a movie is an hour and a half, 2 hours. So I feel like when you go home and you want to go and chill in bed, you might not want to commit to watch a 2 hours movie, but you're okay to watch one episode of a TV show. So I feel like there's a lot of demand, and there is that's why the budgets are getting bigger and the quality is getting better.
Often these successful TV series, they start from a local story and then they become, you know, worldwide successes.
Yeah.
Which kind of Italian local story could be told?
Ooh, if I knew, I would make it. I wouldn't tell you. I would try to develop it myself.
So you also acted in Ford versus Ferrari, the movie.
Yes.
That is gonna be in theaters in November. What can you tell us about it? I mean, how was the experience?
Oh, it was a beautiful experience. It was very different from TV. I came from Grey's Anatomy, which was my first bigger job, and Ford versus Ferrari was my first big cinema job in America. And yeah, it was very interesting how the pace changed in Grey's Anatomy, we do maximum 2 takes per scene, and on the movie we did like 10-15 takes for the same one, so you can play with what you have a little bit more, you can change things up and experiment a little bit more. It is fascinating, but I like both.
So on a personal level, how did your life change since Grey's Anatomy?
It definitely did, in better, because I got the opportunity to be in the room auditioning for bigger and better projects, and so that was a massive step up for me. And it is also interesting to start it being recognized in the streets, or like people tell me like, do we know each other, because they kind of know me but they don't know where from, and that's very flattering and it makes me always very happy. It's been an exciting 3 years since Grey's Anatomy happened.
You're now an Hollywood actress, we can say so.
Can we?
Yes, we can. Okay. And what would you say to another Italian actress, maybe still in Italy, listening an interview like this and thinking, wow, I would like to be like her?
First of all, study English. That's the biggest currency. And then I feel like it's a great moment. You don't necessarily have to come to Los Angeles, because it's very hard to get a visa. It's very expensive. So I feel like you can start with Rome, and there is a lot of productions happening in Rome. But study English, and maybe go to London for a bit. Keep studying, keep improving yourself, keep making stuff, keep doing. And I feel like momentum generates more stuff, and that's how you get to do to pursue the career that you want to. I don't think good things happen from just like staying home and watching TV and playing safe.
Is still Los Angeles the city of dreams?
Of dreams and sadness and loneliness. It's a lot of things. Los Angeles is a very hard city where you, when you work, is beautiful. When you don't, it's hard to keep afloat and stay positive and try to find the will to keep going. Because as an Italian, I miss my family. I miss my friends. I miss home. And so it's not always easy to keep.
What's the secret to keep it positive?
What is the secret? For me, it's to keep busy. Studying makes me, excites me. Like, learning new things really excites me, and it makes me feel like I have a purpose. I have a very long to-do list in the morning. I study French, I study acting, I study old Italian cinema. There is like a huge pool of knowledge that I don't know, that I'm not aware of, and I feel like dipping into that makes me feel happy.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
We were speaking with Stefania Spampinato for Fred Film Radio at the ITTV Festival in Los Angeles. I am Matteo Guidoni. Thank you very much.
Grazie.